Dysphagia simply means difficulty or abnormal swallowing, but it has some serious complications that can be life-threatening for some. In this video, we will explain the physiology of dysphagia, list the causes and symptoms, and explain the diagnosis of dysphagia in the diet order. The swallowing process is much more complicated than most think. There are many parts to the swallowing process that involve forming a bolus, moving it to the back of the throat, and down into the esophagus. In the process, the epiglottis closes on top of the trachea, preventing food or drink from entering the lungs. With dysphagia, any number of problems can go wrong and interfere with normal swallowing function. Our biggest concern is food or drink aspirating into the trachea and lungs, which can lead to pneumonia. In susceptible populations like the elderly and young children, pneumonia can be deadly. Causes of dysphagia can be attributed to physiological or neurological problems. Some of the most common causes are strokes and degenerative muscle loss that occurs with multiple sclerosis, muscular dystrophy, or Parkinson's. Certainly, cancer and radiation of the esophageal area can also create changes to the swallowing function. Much of the time when a person has dysphagia, there will be symptoms such as difficulty keeping lips closed, food or drink spilling from the mouth, and coughing or throat clearing when the person eats or drinks. However, sometimes the patient does not present with noticeable symptoms. When the symptoms are absent, dysphagia may only be suspected when the individual has frequent bouts of pneumonia. Depending on the part of the swallow that is affected and the severity of it, the person may tolerate certain consistencies of food and drink better than others. In order to determine what consistency is best for the individual and to diagnose the swallowing disorder, a barium swallow test can be performed. A swallow study is a radiological study of the pharynx and esophagus while a patient is swallowing food. Various consistencies of food and drink are sampled to determine how the swallow function works and which consistencies of food and drink are safe to consume. It may mean the patient must thicken all drinks and puree or chop all foods. The swallow study will determine the specifics of that diet order. Because of the severe consequences of aspirations with dysphagia, the diet is critical to patient safety. As you consider the physiological problems and seriousness of the diet order, think about what these food and beverages will be. How will food and beverage intakes be affected? Will an individual eat or drink enough when faced with consistency changes?